Hey guys, what's up? So for today's video, I'm gonna do something I've never done before, and it might be funny, it might be stupid, it might be weird and random, I don't know. But I just had this thought in my head yesterday in my car listening to music. I was listening to 679, the rap song by Fetty Wap and Remy Boy. So I wanna just go through the lyrics, read them one line at a time, and just put commentary onto it, what I think about. If it even makes fucking sense, like, who even knows? I do know this song, but not enough that I just think of it and all the lyrics pop up in my head. So this is me, like, blindly reading them, and I'm just gonna, like, respond to each line. And let's, like, really see what music we're dancing to and repeating in the club. I just mindlessly repeat songs all the time, but like, are you ever really thinking about what you're saying and what the meaning is and what they're trying to say, what the message behind the music is? I'm sure someone is gonna be offended by the fact that this is a rap song and I'm making commentary on it. Like, no, I love this song. This is a song that happened to be on when I had this idea, so this is the first song I'm gonna do. You're free to recommend songs below, good songs, confusing songs, funny songs, whatever, for me to comment on if you are so inclined. That can be of any genre. It's not just like me poking fun at rap songs. Okay, it starts with "Baby girl, you're so damn fine though." Okay, that's a compliment. I take that. If a dude came up to me and said, "Baby girl, you're so damn fine," whether it was at the club or it was my fucking boyfriend, I would be like, "Thank you so much." I'm trying to know if I could hit it from behind, though. And this is where men fuck up. Not all men, but skeezy guys are the dudes that just say weird things to you that they think you're gonna respond well to, or the dudes that send the really sexual one-liners to you on Tinder. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you just called me attractive, you're doing so well, and now you had to tell me. You just had to let me know that you're trying to hit it from behind, though. Like, let me just tell you, though, I wouldn't hit it from behind, though. So if you were gonna, like, ride me or something, no. I wanna hit it from behind, though. No. Dudes, just stop with the "you're pretty" and carry on with intelligent conversation from there. "I'm sipping on you like some fine wine, though." Not gonna lie, don't know what this means. A little too deep for me. I feel like I'm annotating now. Back in high school English, which I hated that shit. "I'm sipping on you like some fine wine, though." Like, literally sipping on her? Like, is this supposed to be you putting your mouth on her and giving her a hickey somewhere or something? Or is it like a metaphor? Like, I'm taking you in little by little, enjoying you the way you sip on wine. If that's the meaning, props to Fetty for getting pretty deep with his shit. If it means slurping my lips on your body, again, why? You now have no shot with this girl, bro. There's no fucking shot. Guarantee you, you might even get hit in the face. Next little stanza. "You talking bands, girl? I got it." Okay, we all know bands means like wads of money with bands around it, right? I think I've never in my life held a band or walked around with a band, so I don't know. "You talking bands, girl? I got it." Okay, if you're talking money, you want a rich guy, I've got that to provide for you. Okay, now we're back on a more positive route. Now that I have just sexually harassed you for a second, let me tell you though, I got the money you need. Making a little bit of a comeback here. It's like, you know what? I feel like a piece of meat, but I really need to make my car payment. So let's fucking go, daddy. Benjamin's all in my pocket. So Benjamin's $100 bills. He has a fuck ton of hundreds in his pocket. Honestly, no lie, if a dude told me that, I would straight up, like, not being funny, be like, you should not carry that much money on your person, in your pockets, unless you're trying to get mugged. Like, you should put money in the bank and have a debit card. And also, why do you have so much cash on you? Do you work with strippers or do you sell drugs? If either one is true, I probably am not your future baby mama, but try again next time. That's honestly just unsafe, you know? "I traded in my trues for some robins. He playing Batman, Fetty's gone rob him." Not gonna lie, I know the Batman and Robin reference, don't understand the rest of it. "I traded in my trues for some robins." I don't know what that fucking means. "He playing Batman, Fetty's gonna rob him." So you're gonna rob someone for money now? So that makes sense why you only have cash on you. Dude, again, maybe leave that part out. Like, literally just imagine a dude being like, hey, I think you're so hot. These are all the ways that I want to fuck you. Sorry that that was a little bit disturbing. I do have a lot of money in the bank, though, and I get it from robbing people, and I have all the evidence on my person with 100 bills in my pocket, bitch. Like, imagine a dude coming up to you and that being his opening. Like, you wouldn't even believe that someone would just say that to you. But it's poetic metaphor, understand. It's a song. If we unraveled a country song, which I want to do next, because it's also kind of like songs directed at women, like letting women know what's up, that they like them, whatever, but in a much different hick ass lovey dovey kind of way. And I think if we really went through each line of a country song, it wouldn't make sense either. I got a Glock in my Rari, 17 shots, no 38, as in 0.38. I'm gonna assume that this means the gun has 17 shots to it, or like I have enough bullets to do 17 shots. I don't know, I'm not educated on guns at all. No, 0.38, is that like a type of bullet? Like, does that mean we don't have this kind of bullet, we have a better kind of bullet? Or does that mean the kind of revolver? See, I'm like literally not even hip enough to understand rap songs, but I know all the lyrics and I sing along. But I know a Glock is a type of gun and a Rari is a Ferrari, so he's letting her know he has a gun in his car. I don't know if I would feel unsafe or safe if I was like on a date with someone and they gave me this whole weird spiel and I now know that they rob people, probably now rob them at gunpoint. Is that the gun you use to rob people, sir? Because now I just feel like I'm an accomplice to a fucking crime now. This would be the craziest first date of all time. I need to know. How do you treat your women? But if he like wasn't a creeper and I wasn't getting the vibe like he's gonna fucking shoot me in the head and rape my body, if I wasn't getting that vibe, I would definitely be like, oh, cool, so you can protect us if by chance we're the victims of a random car hijacking. Dope. Okay, now we're at the chorus. I'm like, yeah, she's fine. Wonder when she'll be mine. So he's back and it says, I'm like, so I feel like this is like his thoughts now. Before he was talking to the girl, trying to win her over, now this is his internalization of that conversation they just had. I'm like, yeah, she's hot. Wonder when she's gonna be my girlfriend. Like, I pulled out all the stops. I told her how I'd fuck her. I told her how I'd fucking pay her bills. I told her how I'd be able to afford her that new Louis. And she knows I got weapons on deck, I can protect her ass. Definitely wonder now when she's gonna be mine. She walk past, I press rewind to see that ass one more time. Again, we started really great. She walked past, I press rewind. Oh, that's so cute. You miss me already. You wanna see me walk by again? Yeah, I wish so that I could see your ass again. And I got this sewed up. Remy Boys, they know us. Okay, Remy Boys is like his group, his squad, his homies. He's got it sewed up because they know us. Everywhere we go, baby, people know me. And they're scared of me because I'll fucking kill them with that Glock in my Rari. Remy Boys, they know us. All fast money, no slow bucks. So I make a lot of money all the time. I ain't waiting on a paycheck. No one can control us. Aw, yeah, baby. So basically it sounds like he robs people to get his money, and him and his friends make a fuck ton of money doing this, and they're the best, and no one can control them. Wow, I honestly am like the biggest Fetty Wap fan ever. Like, literally, ask my best friends from college all the time. I was like, Fetty Wap is my husband. I wanna meet him. I wanna marry him. I would have sex with him. Like, I love Fetty Wap. I think he's so talented. Oh my god. But I've never listened this hard to his lyrics, and now, like, I think he might be a little too hard for me. Who knew with that missing eyeball, you know? But tell me why you see me. Is it money or is it me? Oh, so now you give a fuck about how much she cares about you? Fetty's getting sentimental, y'all. I got honeys in my V. Bro, why are you telling her now that you have other hot girls in your fucking car? Or what is your V? Is your V your dude vagina? I smoke 20, smell the weed. See, again now, I think he's trying to get her to like him. Like, I smoke weed all the time. It smells like weed up in here every fucking day. And she's like, God damn it. I've always wanted to be with a man who just reeks of weed. I got robins on my jeans. You see the wings on every pair. Again, we're making a Batman and Robin reference of some kind, possibly. And I don't understand, because I don't know anything about superheroes. I don't know shit about Robin's being on jeans. All you see is Remy boys, you know my N-words everywhere. And if somebody got a problem, we could meet up anywhere. So again, he is really asserting his dominance. He is now for the second time letting this girl know that Remy boys are the kings of the fucking castle, whatever castle they live in. And if somebody has an issue with that, they are ready to fight them to prove their fucking dominance. Honestly, dating this guy seems like you would definitely have a lot of spending money, but you might get, like, murdered. She a cutie and she fine. So, again, she's definitely attractive. If anything at this point, we know that. Make me wanna make her mine. Yeah, we know, bro, you're really trying to date her. She ain't nothing like them bimbos. Well, that's good to know. It's good to know she's not just some filthy, dirty fucking whore. She's nothing like those bimbos. I bet this bitch fucking graduated from Harvard. If you like it, we can swerve, we can light and stain up here. I don't know what that means, but I'm guessing if you like me, we can swerve as in head out of here and we can do drugs? Blowing, pluck it out the window. Pluck what out the window? I'm off her, asked her if her fatty with it. She said that's all her. Got her with the happy feel, I'm about to spoil her. Asked if her fat ass was real and she said it's all her, so congratulations. He's going to spoil her. So I think when push comes to shove, this girl's about it. When you really weigh the pros and cons here, I think this girl's smart for taking him up on his offer and being his girl.